Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. Today topic continuity. In this topic we have to discuss what is continuity, what is epsilon delta properties of continuity, how to check a function whether it is continuous or not, continuity of a function defined on a domain.
Good morning viewers. Today I'm going to explain continuity of a function. This is the definition of continuity in sequence scenario. So first I am saying, what is a real valued function? A function f is said to be a real valued function if its domain is a subset of a real number. The mapping f is said to be a real valued function. The domain of f is subset of a real number. That mapping is called as a real valued function. And also some of the textbook written codomain is also subset of R. Right, now I'm giving some examples. F maps A to B. If A domain is a subset of set of all real numbers, then this function is called as a real valued function. Next, domain is natural number, codomain is any set B. By definition of real valued function, every natural number is subset of real numbers. For that, it is also real valued function. Now I am going to define the definition of continuity in terms of sequence. We then show our definition equivalent to the usual epsilon delta definition. Now, define continuity of a function. Now we are going to define continuity of a function. Let f be a real valued function. The function f is said to be continuous at x naught, which is belongs to domain of f. If for every sequence xn in domain of f converging to a point x naught, then limit n tends to infinity f of xn is equal to f of x naught for every x naught is belongs to domain of f. That means here f is a real valued function. The function f is said to be continuous at a point x naught if every sequence xn in domain f is converging to x naught, then f of xn is converging to f of x naught. That means xn is converging to x naught. That means here xn is converging to x naught, f of xn converging to f of x naught. Then we say that function f is called as a continuous function at a point x naught. If f is continuous at each point of a set S, yes, the function f is continuous at each and every point of a set S, yes, that set S is a subset of domain f, in which case we say that the function f is continuous on a whole set S. The function f is continuous on whole set S. The function f is said to be continuous. The function f is said to be continuous if it is continuous on domain f. Wherever we say that the function f is continuous means that function must be continuous on domain. Our definition implies that the values of f of x are very close to f of x naught when the values of x is very close to x naught. That means when x is close to x naught, the function f of x will be very close to f of x naught. In this case, we say that the function f is a continuous function. Now, the live example for continuity, time is a continuity. The example for continuity, time 1, 2, 3, 4, then again starting with 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 12 and 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a continuous process. So the time is the live example for continuity. Now I'm giving the definition of epsilon delta property of continuity. epsilon delta property of continuity. Before going to define epsilon delta property continuity, now we are going to see one theorem. This is the necessary sufficient condition. Theorem is, a mapping F is a real valued function whose domain is a subset of real numbers. Then F is continuous at x naught, which is in domain F, if and only if for each epsilon greater than zero, there exists a delta greater than zero such that x belongs to domain of F, and mod x minus x naught is less than delta implies F of x minus F of x naught is less than epsilon. This is the necessary sufficient condition, if and only if statement. When F is continuous function, this equation one is holds. This equation one means what? For each epsilon, epsilon is a small positive quantity corresponding to exist delta greater than zero, such that when mod x minus x naught, the difference of x and x naught is less than delta, then the difference of f of x and f of x naught is less than epsilon. When x approaching to x naught, f of x is approaching to f of x naught, then we say that f is called as a continuous function. Now we are going to prove. Actually, it is a basic definition for epsilon delta, but we are going to prove both are equivalent. Now, firstly, I'm taking f is a mapping from S to R with the function S subset of R. That be a function whose domain is S. S is a subset of R so that it is a real valued function. So suppose, firstly, suppose that the function F satisfies the equation one. Firstly, suppose equation one holds. I'm assuming as condition one, equation one is holds. Now we are going to prove that the function F is a continuous function at a certain point x naught. So we are assuming as F satisfies the equation one. And also consider xn is a sequence in S such that, because of our definition, xn converging to x naught, the function f of xn converging to f of x naught, we are going to prove. For that, I can consider limit n tends to infinity xn is equal to x naught. And xn is converging to x naught and anukoni, f of xn is converging to f of x naught and prove cheyabothunna. Yes? Now we need to prove this one. We need to prove limit n tends to infinity f of xn is equal to f of x naught. That means f of xn converges to f of x naught. We are going to prove this condition. For that, I'm taking epsilon greater than zero. By condition one, there exists, because of already we assume that condition one is holds, there exists delta greater than zero such that x belongs to S mod x minus x naught is less than delta implies f of x minus x. It is given condition. We are assuming this one. Since xn converges to x naught, by definition of convergence, already we know sequence of convergence definition. Since xn converges to x naught, by definition of convergence, there exists a number capital N such that n greater than capital N implies mod xn minus x naught is less than delta. So here I'm taking just delta. For each epsilon greater than zero, for each delta, there exists a number capital N such that n greater than capital N implies mod xn minus x naught is less than delta. This is the purely definition of convergence. By using this condition, by using two, you observe when x minus x naught is less than delta, this condition is holds. When xn minus x naught is less than delta, then also this condition is holds. So by using equation two, then for n greater than capital N implies xn minus x naught is less than delta, then f of xn minus f of x naught is less than epsilon. Simply, just a simple idea. X minus x naught is less than, x minus x naught is less than delta implies f of x minus f of x naught less than epsilon. And x minus difference of these two terms is less than delta, automatically functional values also less than epsilon. Same ikkada, xn minus x naught is less than delta, then f of xn minus f of x naught is less than epsilon. So for n greater than capital N implies what happens? F of xn minus f of x naught less than epsilon. And meaning of this is equal to what? Sequence f of xn converges to f of xn. By definition of convergence, the sequence f of xn is converging to f of xn. So that means we can write this as limit n tends to infinity f of xn is equal to f of xn. So this is the definition of continuity. By definition, already we given the definition of continuity is as xn approaching to x naught, f of xn approaching to f of x naught means f is continuous at a point x naught. So since x naught is an any arbitrary point in domain f, therefore the function f of f is continuous on domain f. Now I am putting converse part. Converse part means suppose f is continuous at x naught, then the function f satisfying condition one. So I'm assuming as f is continuous, we are going to prove that condition one is holds or correct. If possible, suppose that we go for proving of this in negative orientation. If possible, suppose that the function f does not satisfy the condition one. The function f does not satisfy the condition one. That means if possible, suppose that one fails. That means what? Then there exists delta greater than zero, so that x belongs to S, mod x minus x naught is less than delta, f of x minus f of x naught not less than, f of x minus f of x naught less than epsilon fails. Fails means what? It is not less than epsilon, which is greater than or equal to epsilon. Which is greater than or equal to epsilon, here I'm writing. Suppose I'm taking delta is equal to here, the small delta value, it is positive value because of n is natural number 1 by n, delta is equal to 1 by n. Then for each n, there exists a number xn. For example, I'm taking n is equal to 1. N is equal to 1, I get a number x1 in S. N equal to 2, x2. Yes, this is in S. These are the members x1, x2, x3, and so on. These are the members in S such that the difference of these numbers, x0 minus xn, is less than 1 by n. Because of already I'm taking delta is equal to 1 by n. For each n, there exists a number xn, such that the difference of these two numbers is less than delta. Delta means 1 by n. This implies mod f of xn minus f of, this condition, f of xn minus f of x naught greater than or equal to epsilon. The meaning of this is equal to xn converges to x naught, but f of xn does not converge to f of x naught, because this is not less than epsilon. This is greater than or equal to epsilon means the function does not converge to this function. అంటే అర్థం ఏమైంది ఇక్కడ ఎక్స్ఎన్ ఎక్స్ నాట్ కన్వర్జెస్ అయితే ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ఎన్ అనేది ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ నాట్ కన్వర్జెస్ కావట్లేదు సో వీ కాంట్ హ్యావ్ లిమిట్ ఎంటెన్స్ టు ఇన్ఫినిటీ ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ నాట్ ఫర్ ఎవరీ ఎన్ వీ కెనాట్ గెట్ లిమిట్ ఎంటెన్స్ టు ఇన్ఫినిటీ ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ నాట్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఎన్ బట్ ఆల్రెడీ దిస్ ఇంప్లైస్ ఎఫ్ కెనాట్ బి అ కంటిన్యూస్ ఫంక్షన్ వెన్ ఎవర్ దిస్ కండిషన్ ఈజ్ నాట్ సాటిస్ఫైంగ్ దెన్ వీ సే దట్ ఎఫ్ నిడ్ నాట్ బి ఎ కంటిన్యూస్ ఫంక్షన్ ఎఫ్ కెనాట్ బి ఎ కంటిన్యూస్ అట్ ఎ పాయింట్ ఎక్స్ నాట్ right? So f cannot be a continuous at a point x naught means this is a contradiction to our assumption. What is our assumption? Assumption is f is continuous at x naught. We get a contradiction. Why we are getting a contradiction? Already we assume f is not satisfying condition one. Condition one is now fails. We are assuming this. For that we get a contradiction. We are assuming this one. For that we get a contradiction. So that our assumption is wrong. Nenu idi correct kaadu anukovadam unna f anedi continuous kaadu ani vachindi kabatti so already f continuous kaakapovadam anedi impossible, which is a contradiction to our assumption. So that equation 1 fails is wrong. Adi fails anedi wrong. Fails means what? Conditions does not satisfy is wrong. So that hence it satisfies the condition. F satisfies the condition 1, right? So when f is a continuous function, then f is a continuous function, then for each epsilon greater than 0, then for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a number. For each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than 0, x belongs to S such that mod x minus x naught is less than delta implies f of x minus f of x naught less than epsilon. So this is called as epsilon delta property or epsilon delta definition also. We consider this one. So by using this property, we are going to prove the problems, the given functions, whether it is continuous or not. By using this epsilon delta property or direct property, we are proving the given problem is whether it is continuous or not at a particular point. Some functions are continuous entire the domain. Some functions are continuous at a particular point. Right? So this is the important theorem in a necessary sufficient part. So thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.